I was about to say...
It's 2023, and there are crops rotting in the fields because there's not enough people to pick them. There are kids going hungry in all our communities, and now we have rationing in our supermarkets. That is not because people are stockpiling and panic buying salad, although you can't keep salad that long, although the lettuce lasts longer than the last Prime Minister. Yeah. I do want the Secretary of State to have some more grip, some more control and some more leadership on this. I think the responses so far have been complacent. So unless she wants to go down as the Secretary of State for sewage, food shortages and rural poverty, what is her plan to properly address the food shortages that we are facing here? Because this is a serious issue for families up and down the country.
It is a serious issue, but I'm afraid that question just shows the lack of knowledge and the bandwagon jumping of the Honourable Member. To try and suggest that there's nobody out in the fields picking vegetables right now, that they're not available right now in our fields. We have a supply chain that brings that food in around from the world. I mean, I'd love to hear about which farms in his constituency are a short right now of people being able to pick tomatoes or lettuces, because I have to say it's probably about as rare as... I was about to say, I'm just about as rare as how successful he would like us to be. Well, what can I put? What's the best way of doing it? Oh, I came up, I had a great one, Mr. Speaker. I don't know, gold at the end of the rainbow. Perhaps he believes in fairy tales. He certainly doesn't know how the food supply system works. He jumps on a bandwagon and he must be embarrassed, and I hope that his constituents reflect the fact that he knows nothing about how their daily lives are affected by this.
We've all obviously just watched the video of Teresa Coffey basically sounding very stupid in Parliament. Now, this video isn't really to defend her, but I just want to tell you about an experience when I met her. So about 5 years ago, I helped the NFU out at the Conservative Party conference. And one of the staff was like, do you want to come on our sign? And you could sign our stand, the NFU stand. You could sign an apple and hang it on a tree to pledge to back British farming. Anyway, she was walking past the stand. One of the members of staff asked her, do you want to come on? She said, no, oh, I can't, I'm far too busy. And I said, it'll only take you 30 seconds. And she went, oh, where are you from? You sound like you're from up my neck of the woods. Anyway, she's from near Liverpool, which I am as well. So anyway, she came on and she signed this pledge and hung it on the tree. And then we got talking about farming, and there was a tractor there, red tractor, Massey Ferguson tractor. I said, come and have a look at it, I'll show you. I bet you never sat on a tractor. So we went to the other side of the conference, like there's all little trade stands, and we sat on the tractor, and I talked to her for 20 minutes about direct drilling, glyphosate, things like that. And she listened and she took it in and she understood. And she also did say that she would come one day and visit the farm. I said, would you visit your family while you're up this way? She said, probably not, because they don't like me because I'm a Tory. Anyway, we found that funny. But then later on, she had a fringe event for the CLA. And in that meeting, she was talking about the CLA and da-da-da-da-da. And she actually started talking about no-till and direct drilling and said that she'd been talking to me earlier and remembered my name. Now, I think she's very clever. And if the right people show around and she sees farming properly, I think she could be good for the industry. But I don't know where she's been, but she might have been living under a rock. Now, she was kind of correct saying that people aren't picking lettuces and tomatoes at the moment in the fields, but they are in greenhouses if they could afford to grow them. So, Teresa, if you're watching this video, if someone shared it and showed it, yeah, you are still welcome to come and visit my farm near Liverpool, and we can talk about farming and see if we can get this farming nation producing more food so that we don't have to import it and we're not exporting money out of the economy, buying food from abroad.